Get ready to match the stars from The Price is Right, Bob Barker, Rex Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Ava Gabor, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Bulifant as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rader!
Thank you, friend. Okay. You're gonna be glad you showed up today, because look who we got here. We've got them all here, and they're all wonderful. Nice to see you again,
Thank
my dear.
You, darling.
And nice to see you again, too. You haven't been around in a while.
No, thank you for having me back.
Listen, Bob, next week, we're going to be following you, aren't
That's
we?
That's right. We're going 1/2 hour earlier.
That's
CBS.
Right.
9 o'clock in the west, 10 o'clock in the east. And the other day, Brett Summers told me they're moving the Brett Summers show to follow us.
That's right. So be sure to tune in next Monday, November 7th. When Match Game will be following The Price is Right. That'll be 11 o'clock in the east, 10 o'clock in the Midwest, and good luck, California. Well, same thing at the same time. Okay?
Very good. You've
all right.
Well done.
Yeah. Really got it all now.
Done.
Let's say hello to Diana Matheson and Ron Kurth. Diana's our current champ. She's won a bundle of money. She has $3,200. Are you happy about that?
I'm sure.
Good. What are you going to do with it?
I don't know yet.
Really don't?
No, not really.
I would have spent it all by now. Now she's got a new challenger here, and we're happy to welcome you, sir.
Thank you.
Ron Kurth, where are you from?
Well, I'm from Chico, California, originally. I'm in the Navy right now. I'm a pilot, and I'm attending Naval Postgraduate School at Monterey for a master's in computer technology.
Really?
Yes, sir.
There's a lot of computerization in piloting a plane these days, isn't there?
Right, there is. They have a lot of mini computers on board that do take a lot of the pilot load away.
What kind of planes do you fly?
Well, I'm primarily a helicopter pilot, but I've flown quite a bit of multi-engine also.
Well, Ron, good luck to you, sir. We'll
Thank
start
you, sir.
This game right after we do a little business with America. Here it is. Here we go. I'll just push this button here and reveal our first round questions and ask Ron to make a decision.
Gene, I think I'll take A.
A it is. All right. Frank said, he says, I don't trust this bank. There's a picture on the wall that says, our founder. And it's a picture of blank.
There's a picture on the wall.
So you see, it says, our founder. It's a picture of blank.
Got it. Oh, I got it, huh?
Love your new hairdo.
Oh, thank you. Your hair doer did it for me.
I don't have a hair doer.
Yes, you do. You should. Oh, I have a present for you.
Yeah, Nikki Scalacci.
Nikki did. I got bored with it.
Yeah.
With the bangs and things.
We all were getting bored with it.
I figured.
What put that answer in the slot? You had something to say?
Yes, I have a present for you.
You have a present
Since
for me?
Since you came over to talk, Mary, my daughter and I went to a county fair today.
Yes?
And they had this hanging up, and it looked as if it was just for you. To remind you of better days.
All right. All right, let's see.
Well, let me see. What is it?
Expect to call today the Encino Motel found your net.
You rascal. Thank you for thinking
You're
of me.
Welcome. Mary saw it.
I love
Thank you, Mary.
Wonderful.
Oh, that's beautiful.
I'm
okay.
So glad, and we didn't know Where's that, did we?
No, we didn't.
At the Benedict Canyon County Fair.
Ron, are you ready?
No.
Good. Frank said, I don't trust his bank. There's a picture on the wall that says, our founder, and it's a picture of blank.
Bert Lance.
Bert Lance, he said. Okay, he says Bert Lance. You like that, Bob?
I love it.
Yeah.
I love it. And I would like to make a match with him. I was a naval aviator. They still had propellers on them when I flew them.
Really?
But I didn't have the nerve to write that down. I thought I'd get only the Republican laughs, you know?
Yes.
And I said, Willie Sutton.
Willie Sutton.
Willie Sutton.
The famous bank robber. All right, what do you say, Brett?
I sure as the devil would have said it if I thought of it. I didn't. I said Dillinger. You're too smart.
Dillinger. You certainly are au courant, if I may say.
Ooh.
Friends.
Watch it, dear.
Read the papers and everything, don't you?
Keeping in...
In keeping.
In keeping. Good, Barbara. In keeping with the middle-aged answers on the top floor, I continue with Alberto Capone.
Al Capone.
I'm sorry.
Ron, I think you're too smart for this room. Ava?
You know, after all these years, I ought to be able to spell better, but I don't. I did say Lance, but I spelled him wrong.
Louse. I'll say wait a minute. Lanz. L-O-N-Z. Yeah. That's very good, Ava.
Is that smashing?
Lanz, she said.
That's L-A-N-Z. Hungarian.
It's a rhythm, it's an accent.
That's right.
She's into agents.
She spells with an accent.
Clothes.
That's it. Throw it in the slot now. Okay, Richard, you're on.
It's as clear as most of his banking things. I said Lanz.
All right, here you go. Now.
I must say that the lower level is so much more intelligent and youthful. And with it, Mr. Lanz.
There you go. Now let's see what we have for Diana. Sylvia said, Larry is driving me crazy. When he gets finished chewing his gum, he sticks at my blank.
I would like to ask a question. Did Diana make that top?
No, my aunt did.
Did you make that?
No, my aunt made it for me.
And it's real crochet work, isn't it? It's beautiful.
Thank you.
This is really very nifty of you.
Don't hang in any place where Helen is.
You know, I thought she was kidding always about that motel, and she was on Price is Right with me, and she plugged the motel there.
Oh, she did? Really? All right, Diana, you ready? We'll have a go at it. Sylvia said, Larry is driving me crazy. When he gets finished chewing his gum, he sticks it in my blank.
In my ear.
Yeah! Ear. We all say, come here, stick it in your ear.
Well, again, the first thing that occurred to me was Bert Lance.
Yeah.
But I said ear.
Ear to ear. One for Diana. It's a baseball phrase, you know.
Yes. In the
baseball
immortal
phrase.
Words of Richard Dawson, stick it in your ear, dear.
He won't say that.
In keeping with the answers on the top floor here.
Here it is. Three for Diana.
That's
Ava, have you ever heard of that expression? It's famous in baseball, in the baseball world.
It is?
They say, stick it in your ear. You know, when a pitcher is throwing at the batter, they say, stick it in his ear, hit it. You know, it's a very hostile thing.
I never heard of it, so consequently I said something else. We might be off the air, but I said.
What did you say?
I said derriere, which, you know.
Stick it in your derriere. We understand. Ava, on this program, when we say show and tell, we really don't mean it.
Sorry, darling, I didn't know you speak such good French.
Yes, I do. Richard, show us your...
You got some gum there.
Got some gum there.
I said ear.
Yeah, all right. Four for her. What do you got there, Joyce?
That's, well, not what she has.
Oh.
But maybe
you does.
She needs it there to make her sit still.
Oh, yes.
I sit in your ear.
Yeah. All right, so this woman scores 5-3. Well, we got a lively game going here. Two good game players. We'll continue it after this. All right, we're going to round two now. And Ron, you may have A or B.
I'll take A, Gene.
A it is. Now, there are three people who will play, the whole top tier.
Oh.
Shame.
Oh. Shame.
Dillinger mob.
The Dillinger mob, right.
I was influenced by them.
Here it is. Farmer Brown's chicken is so stupid.
How stupid is he?
Farmer Brown had to teach it how to blank.
I got that one.
Farmer Brown's chicken is so stupid, Farmer Brown had to teach it how to blank. Okay.
Oh,
Oh, that is beautiful.
While we're messing around.
Mark Breslow, while we're waiting for them to write.
Oh, no, we'll...
No, no one's going to hit you over the head because it's fake.
Is that right?
That's right. I just want to see it. It almost looks real.
Yep. 2C batteries.
2C batteries.
Oh, I know. It's exquisite what they can make today.
Yeah, my mother stole me.
Out of foil.
Farmer Brown's chicken is so stupid, Ron. Farmer Brown had to teach it how to blink.
How to lay an egg.
How to lay an egg. Now, that young fella there, member of the U.S. Navy, has come up with two terrific answers so far. This is the second one, and if you let him down, you're all going
see
to the
how
bridge.
Cold and hard you are, what the show's done to you?
That's right.
When you wear that gray suit and the green suit, you become hard and cold. We might all go with Bob Barker right out to the other side.
The price is right.
Right.
Yeah.
What do you say to that now?
I say you finally came to something I know something about. After 20 years in television, I know about laying eggs. Laying
eggs. All right. There's one for Ryan. He's up to four now. You going to help that boy along, Brett?
I'm going to do my best. You know, you don't need a rooster. I don't want to hurt anybody's feelings. But you don't need a rooster to lay an egg.
That's true. You can, those are called infertile eggs, Charles. Mm-hmm.
Make an egg.
Make an egg.
There you go.
Well, Ron, they finally got with you there. Now, yes, Diana, the best you can do is tie, and you have to match the one person you haven't matched heretofore, and that's Ava.
Oh, my God.
Well,
I'm
no.
I'm playing alone?
No, it's just Jean, Ava.
Is it just me alone?
Just you
How
and me.
Depressing.
Here, now listen carefully now. She's depending upon you. When Harold eloped with Fat Frida, he didn't take her from her bedroom window on a ladder. You know, that's the traditional way
yeah,
they
I know.
Elope,
I know.
A ladder.
I know.
Frida is so fat, he had to use a blank. That's how fat Frida is. Fat Frida.
Frida's so fatty.
Oh, I know. Is it just me?
Just you.
Oh, my. Well, I don't like this solo performance in this.
You don't like to
group.
Perform solo?
Well, I do as a rule, but not here.
I've oh, I see. I hope you'll invite me to your next solo performance. Diana, when Harold eloped with Fat Frida, he didn't take her from her bedroom window on a ladder. Frida is so fat he had to use a blank.
A crane.
A crane. Okay. Now, Diana must match you to achieve a tie and stay in the game, Ava. And
I
she
mean,
said
it's,
crane.
It's a miracle. I mean, it's an immaculate conception, whatever you call it.
Well,
crane.
Not that. She was only kidding about the Immaculate Conception, she was. It's just a game, that's all. So now, we have a tie, so that means we have to turn off all of these lights here, erase the scores, and push this button here, reveal one tie-breaking question for each, and the one who has matched the most celebrities will be the winner. Ron, again, you have a choice of A or B.
I'll go for A again.
A it is. A reads as follows, Ron. Unlucky Louie said, yesterday I bought a candy bar. My lousy luck. When I bit into it, not only were there nuts in it, there were blanks in it. Not only were there nuts in it, there were blanks in it.
Perfect.
Okay.
Maybe we ought to...
Ron? Unlucky Louie said yesterday I bought a candy bar and my lousy luck. When I bit into it, not only were there nuts in it, there were blank in it. There were blanks in it.
Very
bugs.
Good.
What?
Bugs.
Bugs.
That's what I thought.
Well, I don't know. I didn't cross my mind.
I didn't hear what he said. What
he said bugs.
Bugs?
Yeah. Nuts and bugs.
Nuts and bugs?
Yeah.
Well, I'm sorry, Ron. I said nuts and bolts.
Nuts and bolts.
Missed it.
All right, Brett.
Oh, Ron, I'm sorry. I thought it was a shoe-in. I said bolts.
Nuts and bolts. What we're going to find here a lot, I suspect.
Better this way than over the Gulf of Mexico with an engine that's going down.
Right. Yes, Ron, as Charles has implied, you are getting shot down here little by little. Ava, he's looking for bugs.
I ran him into, I said bullets.
Bullets, yeah.
Bullets. Bullets. Not a good idea, I might add.
Right.
Very bad.
That's where the phrase bite the bullet came from.
Not a
buy
good
a candy
idea.
Bar and bite the bullet. Bolts it is. Well, here we go.
I'm good. I said bolts, nuts and bolts.
That's right. That is the definitive answer. Now we're going to pause here for Do a Little Business with America, and then you're in the catbird seat when we come back from this commercial. Now, we will continue with the tiebreaker. And, Diana, all you have to do is match one person, and you will win your third game. Judy said, I'll never again go on a date with Fred. First, he talked my ear off, then he blinked my ear off.
God.
Are you ready, Diana?
Sure.
Here we go. Judy said, I'll never again go on a date with Fred. First he talked my ear off, then he blinked my ear off.
Chewed it off.
Chewed my ear off. One chewed ear is what we're looking for, Bob.
And she only needs one match.
Right.
10% for old Bart. Bit my ear off.
That wins the day. One record. Bit. Everybody hang back. Now, Ron, I hope you have many happy flying hours. It was a pleasure to meet you. Good luck to you. We're going to send you a lot of gifts that I think you'll enjoy. Ron Curtis, ladies and gentlemen. Now, Diana, you know how it goes. It's your third time up here. Let's begin up there by pointing out to you that not too long ago we got a bunch of people in this very room and we gave them writing materials and something to write with, and we said, write down your best answer to this. The light went out again, thank you. Dawn blank. Dawn blank. Now, if you match the answer they wrote down most frequently, you get $500. For matching their second most popular answer, you get $250. And for matching the third, you get $100. Those are yours to keep. And three of our six celebrities will help you.
Richard.
Dawn Patrol.
Okay.
Bob.
Great.
Dawn Great. Dawn. That doesn't make sense.
No, I'm.
Oh, I see. You're
of all the things.
Something may come to you.
Something. You may get an idea,
yes,
Bob.
Yes, I don't like that.
Well, all right, the hell with you.
I didn't. Just a moment.
I didn't mean it. Sure.
Give me a kiss.
All right. I'm running another ad.
We're a friendly bunch here, Bob.
Dawn till midnight.
Dawn till midnight.
Dawn till midnight.
Yes.
That's what she had on the card.
Yes, I see.
Then you were right.
Yes, I was.
Yeah. All right.
I should have got the card from Richard.
Joyce, if you got one third, is the most difficult position.
No, I really think I've got two. I like both of them. I don't know which one
I
to
like
say.
The top one.
Do you? Okay. Dawn's early light.
Dawn's early light. Okay. So you have Dawn till midnight, a sure winner if I've ever heard one. You have Dawn Patrol and Dawn's early light.
Is it too late for me to get my kiss back? Along with my reputation?
You want one of those, or have you got a better idea?
No, I was trying to think of Joyce's. That's what I want. Dawn's early light.
Dawn's early light. What was your other one?
Dawn, not to midnight. Dawn to dusk.
Dawn to dusk. Okay.
Wasn't that the way it goes?
I don't know. Well, this seems like a difficult one to me, but I think Diana's made the right choice. At least I hope so. Let's go down at the bottom there and reveal.
What was that?
A woman blew a horn or something.
Curfew from dawn to midnight. They always blow.
Oh, I see. Yeah, okay. May we see the $100 response? Dawn dishwashing liquid.
Dawn dishwashing liquid. Never heard of it.
I like it.
Procter & Gamble is going to love you.
Oh, sorry.
All right. We are looking for the Dawn's early light. May we see the next one, please? Dawn's early light. You got it there.
How about the first one?
So you pick up another $250. You think it's going to be Dawn Patrol? All right, may we see it, please? Dawn till dusk. That was your second choice.
I'm getting very smart.
Yes, you are. He's combing your hair differently. Your brains are getting some air now, and it's a lot better for you. Well, Diana, you're going to meet another player. No, you're going to have a go at the $2,500 next on the agenda, but right now we've got to do a little business with America. Very bad. Gene Rayburn here. Sit down there now. Be ruly now. Join us next time for Match Game 77. Goodbye.
To remind you of better days.
All right. I know, let's see that.
Well, let me see. What is it?
Expect to call today. The Encino Motel found your rat.
You rascal. Thank you for thinking
You're
of
welcome.
Me.
Welcome. Mary saw it.
I love
Thank
it.
You, Mary.
Wonderful.
Oh, that's beautiful.
I'm
okay.
So glad, and we didn't know we that, did we?
No, we didn't.
At the Benedict Canyon County Fair.
Ron, are you ready?
No.
Good. Frank said, I don't trust his bank. There's a picture on the wall that says, our founder, and it's a picture of blank.
Bert Lance.
Bert Lance, he said. Okay. He says, Bert Lance. You like that, Bob?
I love it.
Yeah.
I love it. And I would like to make a match with him. I was a naval aviator. They still had propellers on them when I flew them.
Really?
But I didn't have the nerve to write that down. I thought I'd get only the Republican laughs, you know?
Yes.
And I said, Willie Sutton.
Willie Sutton.
Willie Sutton.
The famous bank robber. All right, what do you say, Brett?
I sure as the devil would have said it if I thought of it. I didn't. I said, Dillinger. You're too smart.
John Dillinger. You certainly are au courant, if I may say.
Ooh.
Friends.
Watch it, dear.
Read the papers and everything, don't you?
Keeping in...
In keeping.
In keeping. Good, Barbara. In keeping... With the middle-aged answers on the top floor, I continue with Alberto Capone.
Al Capone.
I'm sorry.
Ron, I think you're too smart for this room. Ava?
You know, after all these years, I ought to be able to spell better, but I don't. I did say Lance, but I spelled him wrong.
Louth. He won't say that.
In keeping with the answers on the top floor here.
Here it is. Three for Diana.
That's
Ava,
really
have you ever heard of that expression? It's famous in baseball, in the baseball world.
It is.
They say, stick it in your ear. You know, when a pitcher is throwing at the batter, they say, stick it in his ear. Hit him. You know, it's a very hostile thing.
I never heard of it. So consequently, I said something else. We might be off the air, but I said.
What did you
I
say?
I said derriere, which you know.
Stick it in your derriere. I understand. Ava, on this program, when we say show and tell, we really don't mean it.
Sorry, darling, I didn't know you speak such good French.
Yes, I do. Richard, show us your...
Got some gum there.
Got some gum there.
I said here.
Yeah, all right. Four for her. What do you got there, Joyce?
That's, well, not what she has.
Oh.
But maybe she needs it there to make her sit still.
Oh, yes.
I sit in your ear.
Yeah. All right, so this moment score is 5-3. Well, we got a lively game going here. Two good game players. We'll continue it after this. All right, we're going to round two now. And Ron, you may have A or B.
I'll take A, Gene.
A it is. Now, there are three people who will play, the whole top tier.
Oh, shame.
Dillinger mob.
The Dillinger mob, right.
I was influenced by them.
Here it is. Farmer Brown's chicken is so stupid. Farmer Brown had to teach it how to blank.
Get ready to match the stars from The Price is Right, Bob Barker, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Ava Gabor, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Bulifant as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star. 1957, Gene Rayburn.
Okay. You're gonna be glad you showed up today, because look who we got here. We've got them all here, and they're all wonderful. Nice to see you again,
thank
my dear.
You, darling.
And nice to see you again, too. You haven't been around in a while.
No, thank you for having me back.
Listen, Bob, next week, we're going to be following you, aren't
we? That's right. We're going 1/2 hour earlier.
That's right.
CBS. 9 o'clock in the west, 10 o'clock in the east. And the other day, Brett Summers told me they're moving the Brett Summers show to follow us.
That's right. So be sure to tune in next Monday, November 7th, when Match Game will be following The Price is Right. That'll be 11 o'clock in the east, 10 o'clock in the Midwest, and good luck, California. Well, same thing at the same time. Okay?
Very good. You've
all right.
Well done.
Done
that, yeah.
Got it all
done.
Now. Let's say hello to Diana Matheson and Ron Kurth. Diana's our current champ. She's won a bundle of money. She has $3,200. Are you happy about that?
Oh, sure.
Good. What are you going to do with it?
I don't know yet.
Really don't?
No.
I would have spent it all by now. Now she's got a new challenger here, and we're happy to welcome you, sir. Ron Kurth. Where are you from?
Well, I'm from Chico, California, originally. I'm in the Navy right now. I'm a pilot, and I'm attending Naval Postgraduate School at Monterey for a master's in computer technology.
Really?
Yes, sir.
There's a lot of computerization in piloting a plane these days, isn't there?
Right, there is. They have a lot of mini computers on board that do take a lot of the pilot load away.
What kind of planes do you fly?
Well, I'm primarily a helicopter pilot, but I've flown quite a bit of multi-engine also.
Well, Ron, good luck to you, sir. We'll
thank
start
you, sir.
This game right after we do a little business with America. Here it is. Here we go. I'll just push this button here and reveal our first Ron questions and ask Ron to make a decision.
Gene, I think I'll take A.
A it is. All right. Frank said, he says, I don't trust this bank. There's a picture on the wall that says, our founder. And it's a picture of blank.
There's a picture on the wall.
See, it says, our founder. It's a picture of blank.
Got it. Oh, I've got it, huh?
Love your new hairdo.
Oh, thank you. Your hairdoer did it for me.
I don't have a hairdoer.
Yes, you do. You should. Oh, I have a present for you.
Yeah, Nikki Scalacci.
Nikki did. I got bored with it.
Yeah.
With the bangs and things.
We all were getting bored with it.
I figured.
Go ahead and put that answer in the slot. You had something to say?
I have a present for you.
You have a present
since
for me?
Since you came over to talk, Mary, my daughter and I went to a county fair today.
Yes?
And they had this hanging up, and it looked as if it was just...
Lanzi. Yeah. That's very good, Ava.
Is that smashing?
Lanz, she said.
That's L-A-N-Z. Hungarian.
It's a little bit of an accent.
That's right.
She's into agents.
She spells with an accent.
Clothes.
That's it. Throw it in the slot now. Okay, Richard, you're on.
It's as clear as most of his banking things. I said Lanz.
All right, good to hear you, Ron. Now.
I must say that the lower level is so much more intelligent and youthful. And with it, Mr. Lanz.
There you go. Now let's see what we have for Diana. Sylvia said, Larry is driving me crazy. When he gets finished chewing his gum, he sticks at my blank.
I would like to ask a question. Did Diana make that top?
No, my aunt did.
Did you make that?
No, my aunt made it for me.
And it's real crochet work, isn't it? It's beautiful.
Thank you.
This is really very nifty of you.
Don't hang in any place where Helen is.
You know, I thought she was kidding always about that motel, and she was on Price is Right with me, and she plugged the motel there.
Oh, she did. Really? All right, Diana, you ready? We'll have a go at it. Sylvia said, Larry is driving me crazy. When he gets finished chewing his gum, he sticks it in my blank.
In my ear.
Yeah! Ear. Are we all saying fun? Stick in your ear.
Well, again, the first thing that occurred to me was Burt Lance.
Yeah.
But I said ear.
Ear, ear. One for Diana. It's a baseball phrase, you know.
Yes. In the immortal words of Richard Dawson, stick it in your ear.